few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
There it is. Empire Bay. Tell the truth, you miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry though, a drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito, come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes, we're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal. What was it like over there anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading?
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calò.
No shit. Don Calò. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here. Wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
Salud.
Salud, chin down. How come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
Nah, I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait, you mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't wanna go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here. Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know... The guy's name is Vito Scaletti. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later. Situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl. Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Come on, Friday. You're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you wanna ride?
No, thanks. I want to walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
Can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
Here we are.
All right, thanks. Keep the change.
But the fire is so delightful.
Hey, what's the good word?
How you doing, soldier?
Let it snow, a lot better now that I'm home.
You on leave or home for good?
That's, classified. So, what's new around here?
Tell the truth, not much. Everybody just wants the war to be over. And they're saying this is the coldest winter on record. I wish I had some good news. When we finally
kiss goodnight. Yeah, you and me both. All right, I'll see you.
Catch you later, buddy. But if you really hold me tight,
Vito! He's not yours.
Hello, Mrs.
And the fire is
Vito? It is you. You look so handsome in that uniform. Your mother must be so proud. And what about poor Salvatore Montemaggiore? How's he doing? His poor mother was expecting him home a week ago.
Sal joined the Navy. I'm in the Army. It's different.
Why don't you come inside and have some tea with me, Vito? You could tell me all about it.
Thanks, but I'm kind of in a hurry. I just got back, and I can't wait to see my mother and Frankie.
Such a pretty girl, that Francesca. It's a wonder she's not married yet. Well, say hello to your mother for me, Vito.
But as long as you love me so, let it snow.
Let him go.
Yeah, we'll be right back.
It's just one lousy beer.
Raisin broad.
That's what he said the last time. Then he comes home at 3 a.m. smelling like gin and another dame's perfume.
Hey, Georgie, come on. You don't gotta listen to everything the old lady says, do you?
George isn't going anywhere. Now scram!
That crazy broad's really got Georgie by the balls, huh?
Hey, more beer for us, right? Let's go.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito. Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
So
sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry. Benedice, Signore, pronunciata per la tua volontà. Siamo ricevendo, provvedere al puro cucino di un'altra.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
I'll see you 2 a.m.
Sleep well, mio bambino.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly. Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Pappalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him, work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
I don't give
I'm
a
sorry.
Damn. I don't care
we'll get the
if you
money.
Gotta
sell
everything
I promise.
You got.
What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business,
no.
asshole.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on. Show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse.
Stop, please! Vito, what are you doing?
Ah, fuck this.
Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here.
You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
You now?
It's taking you forever, and I'm cold.
Sit in the damn car if you're cold.
It's cold in the car, too. Hurry up and fix this piece of junk.
It'd get done a hell of a lot quicker if you quit nagging me and give me a hand.
I am not nagging you.
Yeah, uh-huh. Well, if you're as good with a wrench as you were with your mouth, we could have this damn thing fixed already.
You are so useless. It's no wonder the army wouldn't take you.
You had to bring that up again, didn't you?
Ethel's husband, Frank, he's a fighter pilot. Margaret's husband, Charlie, he drives a submarine.
I'm warning you.
My husband? Oh, he's a 4F. He works at the grocery store.
You know what? Fix it yourself then, you lousy bitch!
Hey, need a hand?
Sure do. Hope you're better at this thing than my good-for-nothing husband.
There we go. All done. I just needed to, screw a couple things in.
Really? Well, thank you very much, handsome.
Don't mention. Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
This is bad time.
We ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting for you. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. We have to stop when we can all have fun.
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. You know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, Never mind. You gonna let me drive or what?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while. Hey, whoa, slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason. Hey, Vito. You know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it? You know, you really wasn't too bad behind the wheel. You could still use a little practice, though. Ooh! Get a load of that, baby.
Nice. That's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab your... Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. Hey, Giuseppe, I brought
Hello,
you a
Joe.
New customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
retired,
Bay.
Retired, please. How are you? Papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army will bother you again, trust me.
You see? What'd I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Grazie. Well, you can test it right now. Here. Take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins.
You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock, she opens. Easy.
See you around, Giuseppe. Say Benedict.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry, you'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car. Okay, you still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Possible Grand Theft Auto.
Step on it!
Roger that. Vehicle theft in progress. In pursuit of suspect.
Well, it's not over yet. Lose him. Quick.
10-4.
A buzzer took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. The buzzer tried to throw the monkey off of his back, but the monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right."
All right. Looks like we lost it. So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. I think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs it.
A new set of wheels? Take your pick, pal. Bring it by anytime.
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right.
All right, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. You probably have some work for him.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. Can't miss him.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. My buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters. Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I can see myself in your pants. Here, I got another one. If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
And this works for you.
Here's a good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, don't I?
How about this one? Why don't we go back to my place and play house? You beat the door and I'll slam you.
Oh, that was bad.
Hey, when you measure seven soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift?
Look who's
here. Hey, Mikey boy, what's going on? Shit, Mike, you can wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bath.
Hey, I've been working. Working people occasionally get dirty, you know. Besides, I just wiped them off.
With what? The same fucking rag you used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck?
Put a lid on it. What are you, from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Brewski. But don't shake his hand. I ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
Me and Vito go way back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Uh-huh. Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car. I take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Got it.
God damn it, Mike! You put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune for this thing.
All right, calm down or I'll stick them up your ass, you sissy.
You know, dry cleaning costs these days plenty. And who knows if they can even get this filled out.
You shut up. Vito, listen to me. I need a Walter coupe today. I got a few people looking for parts, but I can't find a car.
Because you don't know where to look. Every time I drive down Hunters, I see one parked by a bar there. I think the place is called the Lone Star.
Isn't that a Moulinyan neighborhood? I'll stick out like a sore thumb.
All right, look, I'll give you $350 for it. It's worth the risk, right?
$400.
All right, deal.
Alfredo, come on, let's go. Andiamo. Meantime, I'll be sending you the cleaning bill for my coat.
Yeah, I'll change my address, you rat prick.
Okay, listen up. This is your maiden voyage, so to speak. So try not to fuck it up, eh? Here, Vito, take this, just in case.
Hey, nice. Hey, Mike, you mind if I test this thing out here?
Sure. Knock yourself out. Here you go. Aim for that old wreck over there.
Ain't a bad shot. Hey, Vito, you should get hit the gas.
Can I leave gas in that thing?
There's a Pollock joke there, but I'll leave it alone.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Fuck you.
All right, that's enough shooting. We got work to do. All right, go out the way we came in and get on the main highway going west. Don't go back through the city. Right up here. So how's it feel to be back?
Good. I feel a lot better with some money in my pocket.
Hey, what's the rush? Money don't buy you happiness, you know.
Get the fuck out of here.
I was just fucking with you. Don't worry about the money. This little job is just the beginning. Pretty soon you'll be rolling in it.
So, Sand Island's still the same shithole it was when I left?
No. The place actually ain't too bad now.
Oh, shit. How the hell that happened?
All the moolies flew south for the winter. Of course it's still a shithole, Vito. You only been gone a couple of years. Gonna take a lot longer than that for that neighborhood to turn around. Them people multiply like rabbits. What are you gonna do? It's even worse than when we was kids. They even got some kind of gang there now. What's their fucking name? The Beamers, the Boomers, something like that. I don't fucking know.
Yeah, that's just fucking great.
Hey, what are you worried about? They're animals. All they do is sell dope and kill each other. They ain't gonna bother a guy like you. And even if they do, that's why I gave you that pistol.
But by the way, you're carrying a gun now? What's the deal with that?
Can't do business without it these days. Especially in this fucking neighborhood.
You, really know how to inspire confidence, you know that? Oh, I forgot how nice this neighborhood was. You know something? One of these days, I'm gonna buy a house.
Look at this guy. Ain't even back a day and he's too good for his old neighborhood.
Hey, what are you breaking my balls for? I'm just window shopping. It'll be years before I know what it is.
You got champagne tastes and beer pockets, my friend. Don't worry, though. I'm going to help you change that. It's that cream-colored baby over there. Be careful. Do it quick and get the fuck out of there. Break a window if you have to and go. I'll wait for you back at Mike's.
Hey, what if I run into problems?
Then you deal with them. Look, consider this a test. If you fail, I hear they're hiring down at the factory.
Right, just asking.
Good luck, pal. I see you back at Mike's.
Hey! Hey, what you doing, motherfucker?
Mission accomplished. How'd it go?
Yeah, piece of cake. Except for the fact that the car belonged to a bunch of moolies who immediately tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Hunters, their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Nice. No stains. Clean.
Where'd the lowlife get the money for this? Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I'd give you for it again?
600.
Oh, I like your buddy, Joe. Here's your 400 bucks. Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All right, boys. I'll see you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman. Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
All right, let's go home. I'm exhausted.
My country road, wild roses grow that need my special care. So I haven't time to be a millionaire. And a cheerful brook on a mountainside is sad.
You should take the highway, Vito.
Well, I haven't time to be a millionaire.
tight. You pulled off that job without fucking it up. Nice going.
Yeah, but I almost got my ass kicked. Didn't live through the war just to die in Sand Island.
Hey, that's all part of the deal, pal. Take it or leave it. Besides, it ain't like you're qualified for anything else.
I guess you're right.
Don't worry about it. It's all gonna be a piece of cake.
So, what's the story with Bruski?
Mike's a good guy to know. He's a little grouchy, but he's always got a scam going. He deals with stolen cars mostly. Spent some time inside a while back. I heard he used to stick up gas stations back in the day.
You gonna make him pay the cleaning bill for your jacket?
Nah, I'll let that one slide. I do a lot of business with the guy. Plus, he's got one hell of a temper. One time we was at the track and some mitt spilled a beer on his wind ticket. Mike beat the shit out of him till he went blind in one eye. Lousy $10. Leave that shit.
Sounds like kind of a scumbag.
Hey, you just gotta know how to handle these people. And Mike's a pussycat compared to some of the guys I met since you shipped out. You'll see.
Hey, is there a safe place to park around here? I don't want to leave this thing out in the street.
Yeah, that's why you're parking your car next to mine in the garage. The streets are full of criminals these days.
Yeah, the neighborhood ain't what it used to be, huh?
And a friendly guy.
If you're hungry, there's some food in the refrigerator. You're hungry, Vito? Take whatever you want from the fridge.